Shake that hand like you're gonna shake it off and say, neighbor, the fire is about to fall. We used to sing in the old church, fire, come on, fire, send down the fire that can burn away sin, the fire that can remove transgressions, the fire that can make you whole, the fire that can give you life, the fire that can forgive sin, the fire that can pick you up and turn you around. Send the fire, Lord, send it on down, send down the fire. The Bible says, the apostles tried to describe it. They said fire lit upon each of us, and we started speaking in other languages. They said we spoke in German, we spoke in French. These are unlearned fishermen and unlearned farmers, but they started speaking in German, they started speaking in Italian, they spoke in other tongues. And the Bible said when they staggered out of the upper room, the people around them did not understand. So they said, these people are drunk. They are drunk. But Peter stood up, said, shut your mouth. We're not drunk as you suppose. But we've had an encounter with the Holy Spirit. It's fell upon each of us, and it's made us bold witnesses to God. Now let me help a sister and a brother out. You do not have to speak in tongues to have the indwelling power of the Holy Ghost. Because I know, Joanne, some tongue talking folk that are full of hell. Y'all ain't got to say nothing. But if you want to know that the Holy Spirit is in your life, can you walk right? Can you talk right? Can you love right? Can you give right? Can you take instructions? Can you behave yourself? Can you obey those who have rule over you? Then you got the Holy Spirit. I need to know if I got about 350 people up in here that got the Holy Spirit in your life, that got the presence of the living God in your life, then that is Pentecost. That's Pentecost, because the Lord is living inside of you. Now there was one more thing that they did. When Peter was talking, then the other 119 got to praising him. Because sometimes when the Lord is talking, you need some praisers. You need somebody in agreement with what you're saying. And if you're going to be in agreement with the Holy Spirit presence in here today, then somebody gonna have to praise him. Somebody gonna have to give him the glory. Somebody gonna have to thank him, because he didn't have to do it. But I'm so glad that he did. He changed my way of thinking. He changed my way of living. He changed my way of talking. He changed my way of walking. So while I'm talking, I need somebody to go to praising God. While I'm talking, I need somebody to go to shouting. I need somebody to go to dancing. I need somebody to go to screaming. I need somebody to go to shouting. I need somebody to remember where the Lord brought you from. Now I'm gonna start talking, and I need somebody to go to praising. Get ready, fellas. I'm gonna talk, and I need somebody to go to praising him. Cause today is Pentecost. It's Pentecost all over again. moving. He picked me up. He turned me around. He took me away from sin. He saved my soul. He made me whole. He healed my body. He delivered my soul. I got to praise him. I'm talking. Ain't nobody dancing. He's the best thing that ever happened to me. Y'all still standing. I need somebody jumping. I need somebody shouting. I need somebody clapping. The Lord is my keeper. He is my refuge. He is my fortress. A very present help in the time of trouble. When my enemies and my foes they stumbled and they fell, for he has encamped around me a host of angels. One thing have I desired of the Lord. I need some dancers, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. It's Pentecost. It's Pentecost. The Lord is here. He's fallen from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. If you praise him, he'll fill you again.